Bonjour tout le monde.
Hello everyone. Over the weekend, we've seen Ontario, Saskatchewan, New Brunswick and Alberta all report new single-day highs of COVID-19. Just yesterday, PEI and Newfoundland and Labrador left the Atlantic bubble as cases increase on the West Coast. And a few days ago, our government approved a request for assistance to deploy in a long-term care home in the Opisquiak Cree Nation in Manitoba. As they always do, our brave men, women and men in uniform are stepping up again to support Canadians and help provinces get the situation under control. The cases we are seeing are extremely concerning, and the federal government will continue to be there for people and small businesses every step of the way. As of yesterday, applications opened for the newly launched Canada Emergency Rent Subsidy. If you own a small business, you could get up to 65% of your business's rent covered, and that goes directly to you, not through your landlord. If your community is in lockdown, we're adding an extra 25% help for commercial rent through the new lockdown support. Combined with the rent subsidy, you could have up to 90% of your rent covered. To help with another big expense for business, payroll, the wage subsidy has also been extended until June of next year. These programs are just some of the many measures we've introduced to have the backs of business owners and workers alike through this second wave. Go to canada.ca/coronavirus to find out what supports are there for you. We know that this second wave had the potential to get really serious really fast. And we also knew that we had to be ready to do whatever it takes to get it under control. Because at the end of the day, lives are at stake. I know you get that. I know you're worried about the people around you. Last Tuesday, I got an email from Jackie in Edmonton. Jackie's worried about her husband, who works in the school system. She's worried about her grandparents and parents-in-law who are in long-term care homes. She's worried about her kids. Jackie, I hear you. You're right. This is a tough time. And I want you to know that you're not in this alone. Our government's top priority is to keep Canadians safe. That's why every step of the way, we've been supporting the provinces so that they can make the right decisions for you. Our supports for businesses and for people mean that local officials don't have to choose between people's health or the economy. And we've been supporting with supplies as well. As of last week, we've sent over 300,000 rapid tests to Alberta and 444,000 face masks. The federal government has also provided $1.3 billion to the province for everything from PPE to contact tracers through the Safe Restart Agreement, with another $260 million for schools in Alberta through the Safe Return to Class Fund. And that's just some of the support we've made available for people and businesses in Alberta, just like for everyone across the country. No matter where you live, we will continue to be there for you through this second wave and beyond. Notre principale priorité est encore d'assurer la sécurité des Canadiens, que ce soit d'acheter plus d'équipements de protection individuelle, d'augmenter le dépistage ou d'investir dans la recherche. C'est là-dessus qu'on travaille. Depuis la semaine dernière, on a fourni plus de 2,9 millions de paires de gants de nitrile aux provinces et aux territoires, et d'autres s'en viennent. On leur a aussi envoyé 4,6 millions de tests de dépistage rapide et des millions d'autres sont à venir. Les gens ont besoin de cette aide essentielle sur le terrain. On va continuer de faire notre part et de leur fournir le matériel dont ils ont besoin au cours des semaines et des mois à venir. C'est essentiel d'acheter et de distribuer de l'équipement de protection et des tests de dépistage rapide. Mais c'est aussi important de trouver un vaccin sûr et efficace si on veut vaincre la COVID-19. Pas plus tard qu'hier, on a eu des nouvelles prometteuses concernant le candidat vaccin d'AstraZeneca et de l'Université d'Oxford. Le Canada a déjà négocié une entente pour recevoir jusqu'à 20 millions de doses. Ce vaccin fait partie de toute notre gamme de vaccins potentiels pour les Canadiens. Et quand on aura un vaccin, le bon matériel pour l'administrer sera essentiel. Jusqu'à maintenant, on a reçu plus de 24 millions de seringues et d'aiguilles, et d'autres livraisons vont arriver toutes les semaines. Ça fait partie de la stratégie qu'on a mise en place pour être prêt quand le vaccin sera prêt. On sait que tout le monde ne sera pas vacciné en même temps. On va devoir établir des priorités. Mais tout ce qu'on fait présentement va nous aider à faire vacciner les Canadiens aussi vite que possible. To keep Canadians safe, we need access to as many potential vaccines and treatments as possible. Today, I can announce that we've signed a deal to secure up to 26,000 doses of a therapeutic drug from Eli Lilly, with options for thousands more. This treatment was developed in partnership with Vancouver's AbCellera Biologics and is part of our support for researchers right here at home who are working around the clock to find a treatment for COVID-19. So to the scientists and researchers across the country, thank you for everything you do. Just like always, your dedication and expertise is making Canadians healthier and safer, and is building a better tomorrow. Canada is lucky to have thousands of world-class scientists and researchers. As a government, we will continue to be there every step of the way to support you in the work you do. Aujourd'hui, je vous annonce qu'on a conclu une entente pour réserver jusqu'à 26 000 doses d'un produit thérapeutique d'Eli Lilly, avec la possibilité d'en recevoir des milliers de plus. Ce traitement a été mis au point en partenariat avec l'entreprise AbCellera Biologics de Vancouver, notamment grâce au soutien qu'on a offert à des chercheurs qui travaillent fort pour trouver un traitement ici même au pays. On va continuer de soutenir nos scientifiques et nos chercheurs qui ne reculent devant rien pour trouver un traitement sûr et efficace contre ce virus. Et je veux les remercier pour tout ce qu'ils font, pour leur pays et pour le monde. The news about promising vaccine candidates that we've heard in the past few days is reason to be hopeful. Our government has worked hard to secure tens of millions of doses, so we're prepared once a safe, effective vaccine is ready for Canadians. But we cannot be complacent now. Remember, if you catch COVID-19 this week, a vaccine in the coming months won't help you. We've seen restrictions increase across the country over the past few days, and Canadians are taking extra care to stay home. But I want to remind you, nothing that we do today will bring the numbers down this week. This week's numbers were already determined by behaviors last week and the week before. What we can affect today is what our country looks like a week, 2 weeks from now. So continue doing your part to keep yourself, your family, and your loved ones safe. Stay at home, wear a mask, avoid social gatherings, especially indoors, and don't forget to download the COVID-19 app. It's easy, free, and quick, and it's incredibly powerful. Just ask Sasha from Toronto. Sasha downloaded the app, and 2 weeks ago, it notified him that he'd been exposed to someone who'd tested positive for COVID-19. Sasha always wears his mask, sanitizes everything, and felt just fine. But he did the right thing and went in to get tested. Well, the test came back positive. He'd been asymptomatic the whole time. If Sasha hadn't had COVID alert, he would never have known. But because of the app, he found out and then was able to self-isolate and keep other people safe. He and his family are almost done their self-isolation, and they've said that they want everyone to know about their story so that as many people as possible use the COVID Alert app. To Sasha and his wife, Kate, thank you for doing the right thing in getting the app, getting tested, and then staying home. And thank you for sharing your story to encourage even more people to make the smart, responsible choice that you did. The more people download this app, the stronger it becomes. So join the over 5.4 million Canadians who, like Sasha, have downloaded the COVID Alert app. Plus les gens téléchargent cette application, plus elle est efficace. Alors, faites comme les 5.4 millions de Canadiens qui ont téléchargé l'application Alerte COVID. Hier, j'ai eu l'occasion de discuter avec des élèves et des enseignants de l'école catholique Saint-Martha de Kingston en Ontario avec notre député local Mark Gerritsen. Alors, j'aimerais conclure aujourd'hui en m'adressant directement aux enseignants et au personnel de soutien qui nous aident à éduquer nos enfants pendant cette épreuve. Je sais que cette année a été difficile. Je sais que vous allez continuer de faire tout ce que vous pouvez pour aider nos enfants, pour élever nos enfants, pour instruire nos enfants. Mais c'est vraiment pas facile. Vous vous mettez à risque, mais vous allez au-delà de tout pour appuyer nos enfants et leurs parents. Merci. Je sais le genre d'engagement que ça prend pour être prof. Je sais ce que vous faites comme enseignant. Et je peux vous assurer que tous les Canadiens vous en sont profondément reconnaissants. Continuez votre excellent travail. Continuez d'être là pour nous comme nous allons être pour vous.